friends, Ms. Skidema here. I will try to keep this as short as I can for you. Some of you have used the dance party coding before and some of you have not. So I will try to quickly show you how to do this. Also, I'd like you to go through the dots up top if you've never done this before. It'll help you as you get to the end and create your own dance. So just to let you know that you change the music here. And the setup block is sort of going to be like a repeat block. And whatever you need to do, like this needs a dancer block. So make sure you're looking up top to see what color block you need and what to do. Here's the directions. And you'll click and you'll move. And once it's ready, you will run it. Here we go. All right, you'll always press continue to move forward. So in puzzle 2, it's a video. I'd like you to play it if you've never done it before. Again, take a look at what's up top. So this is going to be the dance move, and this is like a function when you press the down button, but it doesn't have to just be down. It could be up or right. Try not to get too difficult with ABC stuff or you'll forget what to do, okay? So what the code says is on the setup that you're going to have a cat dancer in the center, and up top it wants you to add a dance move to the green block, okay? So when you press up, it will clap. Again, you could change it if you want. Maybe you want to do a body roll. And by the way, these click down arrows, you can choose a sloth or cat. I'm going to leave it. So when you run it, your cat is going to be in the center and will dance when you press the up key. Here we go. Sometimes it's this one. All right. In the setup, right now I've got a cat at the right and a bear at the left. When I press up, my bears are going to do a high clap. Okay. When I press down, I'm also going to need my cat to do something. Make sure that your dancers match. That if you have a bear here, that it says bear here. So, right now, I'm going to move this down. I have no sloth in my setup, so I have to change this. I've got a cat and a bear. Okay, cat to cat, bear to bear. All right, let's, oh, by the way, we're going to press up and down. Here we go. Okay, so whenever you get this message, that means something went wrong. So dear friends, I didn't give a dance move here, okay? So if you get it wrong, you pull it off and then you pull it back on, okay? Again, so the dance move for the bears, the dance move for the cats, okay? You'll get a cat and a bear. So just to let you know, if you mess up, you just pull it off and over into the trash, and then you run. Now, I could make a new sloth in the center. I could add this too if I want. Okay, just move these down a little bit. Here we go. Run, and I'm going to press up and down. Okay, I did it. Okay, watch the video if you've never played Dance Party. All right. After 4 measures, we need to add a dance move. That's what it says. After 4 measures, add a dance move. So let's do that. Okay. Now keep in mind what I said earlier. Your shark will be in the center, so you want your shark to dance. And if you change it to a bear in the center, okay, then make sure that your bear is dancing. By the way, we can also add a couple new dancers. Red blocks are dancers. So here I can have a sloth be there. I'm going to add a shark center left left. I want one at the right. Okay, here are my dancers. Here's what they're going to do. Okay, I could also add on a dance move for each of them. Okay, Here we go. Let's do double down. All right, but I have two sharks here. I want to make sure that I have the bear, sloth, shark. So I need the sloth here. Okay, bear, shark, sloth. Here we go. After four measures, floss, double down. Let's have the bear do drop. And I can change my music if I want. Okay, it could be whatever you want. I'm just going to randomly pick one. Here we go. Measure four. Okay. All right, friends. Backgrounds. So I'm not going to worry about this other stuff. Right now I just need a background movement, a background effect, I should say. I can change it to be whatever I want, black and white. I also need to add this block where I'm going to get an error. After six measures, I'm going to need, let's see, I'll do the frog. Frog is my only dancer right now. I can add a pineapple if I want. Okay. After six measures, I'm going to have the pineapple clap pie. That's fine. The frog's gonna floss. That's fine. Okay, here we go. All right. I'm going to keep moving here. I'm sorry this has taken so long. So now we're going to have some different background dancers, and they're going to be here in the setup. We want them to begin with us. So let's just have them do 10. We can have this be different. 10 sloths in a circle. And we're going to have all of them do the gingham. That's fine. When we press up. When we press up, all the sloths are going to do gingham. Let's see if this works. Okay, right now my background effect is set for ice cream. That's fine. Let's do neon. Neon, sloths, they're all going to do this. Let's try it. And again, if we're unsure what to do, look at the top. It tells us what we need. Backup dancers. Okay. I could have a unicorn in the center. I could do that too. Okay. So neon's going to happen in the background. Sloths are going to make a circle. I could change this. Okay, they could be on the border. My unicorn will be in the center. And right here, they're all going to do the gingham when I press up. Run. Up. Up. All right. Okay, again, watch the video if you've never played this. All right, every dancer has a set of properties that controls what it looks like. So they want us to use this size, and they put it under the green event block, okay, to appear farther away. So I have to use the size, and it wants it under the green block. So let's do that. Size, this one, and I can change it if I want to. Let's just see what this looks like. Okay, right now I've got cool background, pineapples are in a row, the duck is in the center, the pineapples are going to do fresh, the ducks are going to do fresh. Let's change that in a minute. Floss. Dab. Here we go. Run it. Right. Again, I can change my music here if I want. Now lots of stuff is happening, and what we're going to do now is we're going to use a tint button, and it's blue. So dancers have a tint that can add a layer of color. Try changing the tint of one of your dancers. Okay, so my dancers right now are bears, and I can change their color. Put it in the setup. So unicorns and bears, Right now my unicorn at the center, the unicorn, is going to be changed to this color. So I'll show this to you. I could have her be pink, the unicorn. Okay, it wants this here. Okay, I could also have my bears be different sizes or whatever. This looks fine to me. You can change them if you want. Oh, let's get a background in there too. Okay, here we go. Jonas Brothers, Run. Okay. All right. This is a repeat block. So now every two measures it will repeat something. So what does this want? Well, we have a repeat in there right now. Black and white, it's going to repeat a background effect. And they're all going to do, let's have them all do a body roll. Let's try this. So we've got 16 robots that are going to make the border. They're going to be on the outside. A unicorn's going to be in the center. All right. After every two measures, the background's going to change to random. Okay. And they're all going to do a body roll. Well, let's go back to random. Let's have them do whatever, like change their dance moves. So let's get started. We're going to run. Here we go. Again, you can change the song if you like. Alright, I press the finish button. Alright, so here we go. We've made it to the end where you get to make your own dance moves. And this video will probably be important to you. So, now, all those things that we've practiced doing, you'll be able to do here. Alright, so my dancers, I can pick what kind of dancers I want. I can pick what kind of world I want, the background effect here. The properties include making the size or tint here, and some sort of event if I want to repeat something. So I'm going to pull this one out. When pressed up, I want my aliens to do a dance. I want my aliens to do a dance. Purple blocks are dance moves. I want aliens to do the floss. Okay, notice how I pulled the dancers out. Red blocks are dancers. Okay, dance moves are purple. All right, and this can, oh, we can do the bass too. Okay, all will begin rotating when they follow the bass. All right, let's try that. Let's see what happens. Probably put that one here. Let's see what we do. Okay. Aliens as a circle, the moose in the center. You can change this. When pressed up, my aliens are going to floss. Let's just give it a try. Okay, and I'm going to run it, but I just don't like that song really. Okay. And I've finished. And I could keep playing with this to do whatever I need to there. All right. I hope this was helpful. I know it was long. I didn't want it to be this long, but you got a chance to see all the different things you can do with Dance Party. Okay.